consider both informal assessment, observational and clinical judgment, and formal assessment, using risk assessment tools and clinical judgment, to help us identify if someone is at risk of developing skin damage. On first contact from any health professional, a formal risk assessment tool, i.e. Waterloo, should be used to support the informal assessment in all health and social care settings. This tool was developed to enable the early detection of patients and clients from developing skin damage. This will enable the clinician to reduce the risk by repositioning or the use of pressure redistributing equipment. The assessment tool looks at certain factors which have been shown to influence an individual's susceptibility to tissue damage. Prior to completing the Waterloo assessment, a MUST, Malnutrition Universal Screening Tool, assessment needs to be completed for each patient. When completing a Waterloo assessment, the healthcare professional should always introduce themselves to the patient, ask what Mrs. Smith likes to be called, and explain what they are going to do.
Hello, Mrs. Smith.
Hello.
I'm Paul, one of your nurses today. Do you mind if I inspect your skin to see if there's any pressure ulcers? And also I'll be asking you some questions.
That's all right.
The first part of the assessment relates to gender and age. As Mrs. Smith is female, she'll score 2. But why do women score higher than men? There are several reasons why women score higher than men. 1. Reduction in hormones, estrogen. 2. Loss of tissue integrity. 3. Weight, whether increased or decreased. 4. Anatomical differences. Age also plays an important part of the Waterloo assessment. Mrs. Smith is 74 years of age, and so scores 3. Malnutrition screening tool. The next section is very important when assessing a patient for potentially developing pressure damage. The MUST score will have been completed as part of the total assessment process.
Have you lost any weight recently, Mrs. Smith?
On checking the MUST score, Mrs. Smith has recently lost weight, and this has been estimated at about 5 to 10 kilograms in the last 2 weeks. Therefore, she requires an additional nutritional assessment. The health professional needs to assess whether or not this is a concern, as this could indicate an underlying health problem which would need further investigations. From the MUST assessment, the health professional must establish a body mass index, BMI. The most accurate way to do this is to weigh the patient and ascertain the height. However, in a patient who is unable to be weighed or measured, an alternative method is used during the MUST assessment. Mrs. Smith's BMI is 26. Continence. Mrs. Smith does not have any continence problems at present, therefore there is no score attached. Skin type, visual risk areas. The health professional needs to take this opportunity to complete a full skin assessment with the patient's consent, taking into account the patient's privacy and dignity, closing blinds and or curtains. It is important that the health professional uses their professional judgment when undertaking a full assessment.
I'm just going to inspect your skin now, Mrs. Smith.
As some patients are able to check their own skin integrity and will give a true history, or are clearly very active, there needs to be a concise record within the documentation of the rationale and outcome for any decisions made. Skin inspection helps us identify early changes in the skin's integrity, as the health professional will be looking for areas of redness, erythema, when we inspect the skin. If nearby skin appears normal in colour, the area of redness may be an early warning sign. Pressure points. Any skin lying close to a bony prominence can be vulnerable. On inspection, Mrs. Smith had no skin damage, but had very dry skin on her lower odematous legs. All patients should have pressure ulcers assessed by a health professional. It is important you are aware of how to examine the skin and identify which type of skin damage you are observing. Good skin assessment can help to determine which treatment the patient might need with respect to pressure relieving equipment and wound dressing. Grading identifies the level of skin and tissue damage present. Mobility is a vital deterrent against developing pressure damage. In Mrs. Smith's case, she is restricted due to her walking sticks, therefore scores 3. Apathetic refers to a patient having lack of concern, interest, and being unmotivated. Restricted is when a patient cannot mobilise without aids or due to pain. Tissue malnutrition. This section refers to the past medical history or underlying medical condition, which could impact on the risk of pressure damage. This could be one or multiple conditions.
Mr. Smith, I'm just going to look at your medical records now to see if there's any past medical history that can contribute to you getting a pressure ulcer.
Healthcare staff would need to ask the patient or family, if appropriate, or alternatively access medical records to ascertain the following information. In Mrs. Smith's case, she does not score in this section. Neurological deficit. This relates to patients presenting with problems around long-term conditions, which have a direct impact upon the patient's susceptibility to pressure damage. The score for diabetes, multiple sclerosis, or cerebral vascular accident would depend upon to what extent the patient's daily living is affected by their condition. For example, take diabetes. A poorly controlled insulin-dependent diabetic who shows signs of health effects from the condition, such as poor eyesight, neuropathy, or frequent collapse, would score 6. Whereas a diet-controlled stable diabetic would only need to score 4. However, all patients with diabetes are at greater risk of skin damage, therefore this has to be acknowledged. None of these relate to Mrs. Smith, so we do not have to allocate a score. Major surgery or trauma. This assessment links to the length of time patients are on the operating theatre table during surgery and following post-operative recovery. Once recovery is complete and the patient is mobile, it is not identified as a problem. None of these relate to Mrs. Smith, so we do not have to allocate a score. Medication. Several groups of medications can have a detrimental effect on skin integrity and healing outcomes. For example, cytotoxic medications are drugs which have a toxic effect on cells, commonly used in chemotherapy. This toxic effect damages your immune system, which puts you at greater risk of developing pressure damage and is also detrimental to the healing process. Steroids and anti-inflammatory medication, often prescribed for arthritic patients, influences skin repair and the inflammatory process, which aids healing. None of these relate to Mrs. Smith, so we do not have to allocate a score. This is the end of the assessment. Adding up all the sections gives Mrs. Smith a score of 14. This identifies that she is at risk of developing pressure damage. In this instance, your actions would be to develop a pressure ulcer prevention plan in line with the trust policy. From this assessment, you need to identify with the patient a patient-centered care plan which will meet the patient's needs. Reassessment should be carried out regularly, but the frequency will depend upon the individual needs of the patient. As per DCHS policy, minimum weekly in community hospitals and monthly in community settings. But as your knowledge and skills on pressure ulcer prevention grows, you will find that you will informally reassess each patient's risk every time you care for them. This will help determine the frequency of any reassessments.